We are on MCA TV at Birth Congress 2018 in Venice. We are with Dr. Brianna Despina from National and Capodistrian University of Athens. Welcome.
Thank you.
Cerebrovascular injury is one of the most disabling damage for preterm newborns. Which practices should be improved in order to minimize cerebral injury?
First, I would like to thank the organizing committee for giving me the opportunity to attend this meeting and participate in this meeting. And I would like to thank you for giving me the opportunity to address this important issue. It seems that brain lesions, including ischemic and hemorrhagic injuries in preterm infants, are main and detrimental consequences of premature birth. And a matter of great public health importance because of the increasing number of preterm infants who survive with severe neurodevelopmental disabilities, including major cognitive deficits and motor impairment. It seems that blood fluctuations in the brain of the preterm infant and changes in the temperature of the delivery room when preterm infants are resuscitated and the changes in the respiratory support that we give to the preterm infants may initiate an inflammatory cascade leading to brain injury. And the premature brain is very vulnerable to oxidative stress as well as ischemia and hypoxia. And therefore, many studies nowadays focus their attention on factors that may contribute to brain damage at birth and before birth. And those factors include hypothermia or hyperthermia, on the other hand, and low oxygen saturation in the brain and high tidal volumes that we deliver during respiratory resuscitation. And these things seems to contribute to serious neurologic injuries already at birth. Therefore, the suboptimal management of preterm infants at birth may contribute to serious brain injury. And the implementation of our knowledge regarding the causes and the prevention of brain damage in premature infants must be initiated already at birth. Therapeutic and preventive strategies include the correct timing of cord clamping, strategies in order to reduce the risks for hypothermia and hyperthermia, and strategies in order to reduce the risk of hyperoxia and hypoxia. Furthermore, we can apply and we can administer some postnatal medications, including caffeine and novel therapeutic approaches such as antioxidants and hormones and stem cells. And these can as well improve the long-term neurodevelopmental outcome of preterm infants. Therefore, implementation of our knowledge regarding the causes and the prevention of brain damage in premature infants should be initiated already at birth and not later when the premature infant is going to be admitted in the neonatal intensive care unit, because this seems to be the key to prevention.